This is called the cafe. The seer stared down the prophet in the cafe at the end of the universe. Coffee is a little tepid, she said, and stirred it with the tip of a long, graceful index finger. We've been sitting here for far too long. Still, we're getting nowhere. He grunted, shook his long, dirty blonde hair, and frowned at her under his stern eyebrows. The conversation had dried up a while ago. They'd been languishing in the cheap, foldable metal chairs, staring out at the stars and nebulae off in the distance for quite some time now. The service here is terrible, he muttered under his breath. Saw that coming miles away, he said a little louder. One of the nebulae bore a strange resemblance to a kitten knocking a glass off a shelf. It was a rather sickly green and purple-looking kitten, but still. The other looked vaguely like a pink oxen skull. The stars wound through the middle like a dotted ribbon of lights and gossamer. There really wasn't a nearby star to light up the asteroid they were on. It was really a cafe that was somewhat suspended on the edge of reality and on the verge of some otherworldly place anyway. Not quite in heaven, but perhaps close. The stars and nebulae gave off the faint light that approached the light given by a full moon on Earth. Where the warmth came from was another mystery. Ancient iron street lamps, like something out of a C.S. Lewis novel, dotted the path leading up to the cafe. The cafe itself had cheap runner lights on the ceilings inside. It might as well have been plucked right out of the 80s on Earth and dropped gently on this desolate rock floating around in space with its inexplicable atmosphere. From the tabletop jukeboxes to the cigarette machine in the corner, it practically screams suburbia. Currently, Zombie by the Cranberries was playing over the speaker. Padding on the seat was a teal green paisley print, and the carpet inside was a dirty green. The red counter had red stools that grew directly out of the floor. You want to know what I see out there? She asked. No, he said. You believe you already know then? She inquired. He frowned at her and looked off in the middle distance in the direction of the kitten. Nebula. You know that destiny is like a branch or like rivers, don't you? There's never just one fate, never just one path. He made a sour face and set down his half-full mug of now cold coffee and walked over to the edge of the patio upon which they sat. You talk about the path most likely to be chosen, the well-beaten path. Well, I always take the road less traveled. I don't go down the path of least resistance, she said. She gestured to a constellation that looked like a horseshoe. There's that, she said. This pulled out her keys where a fake purple rabbit's foot straight out of the 70s dangled. And this, she handed him a five-leaf clover in a plastic Ziploc baggie, the kind that beads normally come in. It was a little wilted, but clearly a five-leaf clover. You believe in luck, yes? You know you're nuts, don't you? He said, but he took the clover from her. Yeah, but she gestured at the kitten, the Cheshire cat that all the best people are. December 5th, 2023.